does not mean carelessness. Grace does not mean lack of temperance. Grace does not mean lack of virtue. Grace does not mean that one should not be godliness. God bless you. Are you still happy with me? Do you have this in your hand? Bishop. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Now, spiritual gift and what? Individual ministry. I will beg us in the name of the Lord. Let me say this one before the bishop is here this morning. Whenever you are entrusted with a certain responsibility, one should do it in the fear of the Lord. Well, I thank God for the bishop that gave me the grace to be able to do this before the church. And I try with all possible grace upon me to do with sense of responsibility and be objective. And let me reveal this. Most of the time, I send it to Bishop-elect. Am I right? At least Thursday. So he can read through. If there's any correction, he call me. There's any omission, you call me. It's for check and balances. One must not abuse trust. So, and for that reason, whatever we have here, take it to anywhere in the world. Go and verify, go and study. You will, at least if not 100% correct, it will be minimal error in the teaching. We try as much as possible to make it biblical. And what you see here, you will see that it's most things that cause lack of growth in the church because we don't understand it. Churches grow by ministry. By what?
Ministry.
Churches grow by ministry. Not by prayer alone. And that's what we are trying to for you to understand. When you understand your gift and your ministry, it makes preaching the gospel, witnessing so easy and simple. And it hastens church growth. Every growing church has churches where members are conscious of their purpose of creation. The reason why God creates you and sent to this earth is not to come and do a job. It's to serve Him. God created it for a purpose. And when you know the purpose for which you are created and you begin to fulfill it, it becomes easy. So let's go now. Spiritual gift and individual ministry. But none of these things move me. Neither count I my life dear unto myself, so that I might finish my course. You can take off your pen. As we do this, you can underline. You know, Paul said, and as I finish my course, you can, he said my, he personalized it. He knew this is the assignment God designed for me, which I must finish. So you also must know the assignment that heaven designed for you to perform on earth and in this church that you are now. Recognize it, discover it, recognize it and perform it. And the ministry, look at it, and what? And the ministry which I have received of the Lord, Jesus. The ministry which I have received. Not we. Ministry is not we. Ministry is I. It's like an arm, an eye, a nose, a leg. They are member of a body. You are member of a body. Your particular service is your ministry to the body. Ministry means ministration to the body. The particular area where you are ministering to the body, that where you are contributing, where you are serving, is like a football team. You have left wing, right wing, you have the back, you have the striker. They are all one body working together for same goal. Now, let's go on. Spiritual gift is distributions of work for every believer. When you talk of spiritual gift, it is nothing than distribution of work, like in a large company. In a large company, from the rest of the entrance, you meet the first person who? Security. After security, what? Receptionist. And then, every one of them has a certain job to do. The security man has his own job. He thinks like what? Security man. And the reception girl, when he think like what? Receptionist. And the doctor inside doing operate the surgeon. When the surgeon is thinking, he think like what? When a lawyer is thinking, he think like what? When a prophet is thinking, he think like what? Always attentive to hear from God. When a teacher is teaching, he think like what? When a giver is thinking, he think like what? How to make money and how to give. And where to give. Your thinking will always be programmed according to your spiritual gift. Your thinking will what? Always be programmed, unconsciously or consciously, according to your spiritual gift. If you have a pastoral gift, your thinking will always be about your sheep. When you are an evangelist, your thinking will always be evangelistic. Everywhere you are, you want to do evangelism. You always look for opportunity to preach. Because that is the area where God wired you to operate. A navy will think like what? Think of water and how to drive the water. And the same thing, the Air Force will think about plane, how to parachute. And the land soldier will think about how to move in infantry. That is how ministry functions. Are we going on? Job, what is job? Job is something or services that you render to any person or company for your personal benefit. Ministry is not job. Proverbs 16:26. See what it says. He that laboreth for what? For himself. For his mouth craveth it of him. When you go and do work, it is your mouth that drives you to work. You must eat and pay bill. But ministry is not for yourself. Ministry is to bless people. But your job is to bless yourself and bless your family. Your job is not a ministry. Bible says so. He that labored, he that got the job for himself. When bishop stand now to preach, he's not preaching to himself. Today you must be healed. Today you must be delivered. You must shine. You must rise. You must be a millionaire. It's not for himself, it's for you. But when you go for a job, all you are working for is for yourself, your interest, and your needs. When Christ came, all his life, he used it to bless people, to heal the sick, raise the dead. You know it. He's not working for himself. Listen to me. Every tree is appreciated because of their fruit. Every man is appreciated because of what he can offer and the gift you have in you. Solution you can perform. Nobody like you. Nobody knows what? Nobody like you for anything. Forget about the like you. Nobody like you for anything. People like you for what you can offer and what you can give. Problem you can solve. The day you become irrelevant, people forget you. Am I talking? From the moment you begin to be irrelevant, you are forgotten. So, for you to be relevant, that means you are useful. Anywhere you are, you must be useful. That is when people shall recognize you and see you. But if you are useless, and irrelevant. They will not know you are around. I didn't come to church. Nobody asked of me for 3 months. You are useless. If they know you by your service, if they know you by your giving, by your tithing, and they miss you for 2 weeks, they will call you. I'm a pastor. Am I talking? Amen. If those people beating, using this piano did not come throughout today, won't you miss them? Mm-hmm. The person beating drum did not come throughout service, won't you miss them? That's where life is. If Bishop elect did not come for 2 Sundays, won't we ask of, yes, Bishop elect, yes, Reverend Young, yes, Bishop Young? Because of usefulness. So when you know a principle and you are breaking it, you are wounding yourself. You know that the only way to recognize anywhere you go, even where you are working, even your company, is to be useful. If you are going to work, you are coming late, you don't work. When they are looking for those to fire, you be number one. Am I communicating?
Amen.
So these are principles you have to be conscious. We have to be conscious of it every day. Then, why ministry is something you do for Jesus' benefit? For what? Expecting your reward from God as he has promised. There are lay ministers and also full-time ministers that does nothing else than perfecting the saints. Provision for the welfare of full-time ministers are in the Bible. Like Ephesians. Let's not quickly pass through. We have to be aware of these things. Ephesians 4:11 to 12. And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers. The following verse. For the perfecting of the saints. They have the higher work in their hand that oftentimes require to be full-time. For the work of the, you can see, for preparing them for what? For the work of the ministry. So what we are doing now is preparing you for the work of your ministry in the body of Christ. For the edifying of the body of Christ. The purpose of your ministry is to edify the body of Christ. Then, let's see Romans chapter 15, verse 27. It says, it has pleased them, verily, and their debtors they are. For if they Gentiles have been made partakers of their spiritual things, of what? Their spiritual things, their duty is also to minister unto them in what? In carnal things. So those that are appointed or called to bless you and perfect you for your ministry, you also that do business and do work, it is your duty to bless them. It's not a matter of begging or pleading or cajoling. No. It is a responsibility. Then, 1 Corinthians chapter 9, from verse 9, for it is written in the law of Moses, thou shalt not muzzle the mouth of the ox that treadeth out the corn. Do God take care of oxen? You know, in those days, there's a way they tie the oxen with a big stone. If you have been to Israel, in the a kind of Galilee, you will see the stone with stick inside. So those oxen that drag it to press the corn or the maize or the plow, it is against law to muzzle their mouth. Because they are the ones doing the labor. And there's no amount of food that we eat. Once they are filled, they will stop. So the Lord said they must never muzzle the mouth of the animal that do the labor. Paul now said, was God so concerned about animal? He said, no. Verse 10, or say he eat all together for what? Our sakes. For our sakes, no doubt. This is written, that he that ploweth should plow in hope, and he that threshes in hope should be partakers of his hope. That means when you are laboring, your labor must be with what? Hope. When you have a job, you have to hope that in 15 days I will get this. The same thing ministry. So when you have been quick, those blessing you, you should give them hope. Am I communicating? Then the following verse, if we have sown, can you see, unto you spiritual things. Is it a great thing if we reap your carnal things? The consciousness of it must be you. Then, the following verse, can we go on? The following verse, 11. If we have sown unto you spiritual things, is it a great thing which I reap your carnal things? Nehemiah 10, 37. Nehemiah chapter 10, verse 37. And that we should bring the first fruits of the dove and our offerings and the fruit of all manner of trees, of wine, of oil, unto the priest. So to the shepherds of the house of our God and the tithes of our ground unto the Levites. Unto the what? Levite. And that the same Levite might have the tithe in all the series of our tillage. Because they are on full time taking care of the tabernacle, the temple, all the affairs of spiritual affairs. So God has a provision for them. Let's see what follows in chapter 13 from verse 10 to 12. And their brethren, Shebayana, and Peter Keller, go on, 11. No. 13 is 13. 13 from verse 10, chapter 13. And I perceive, look at Nehemiah. Nehemiah was a prophet, he was a governor, not a Levite. But he fought for the Levite that took care of the temple and spiritual things. And I perceived that the portions of the Levite had not been given them. For the Levites and the singers that did the work were fled, everyone to his field. When they were hungry, everybody ran to their work to go and find job. And they neglected the temple. They neglected what they do, all their services, representing God among them. And what happens? Then contented I with the rulers and said, why is the house of God forsaken? And I gathered them together and set them in their place. 13, or it's 12, verse 12. Then brought all Judah the tithe of the corn and of the new wine and the oil unto the treasuries. And all the Levite that has gone for famine, they all returned to the temple. If you study it all, and God began to bless Israel. Am I communicating? So the two can be one and the same. A preacher has both a job and a ministry. Has both what? A job. You can see Bishop now, sometime in the midnight, in the morning, on phone, or real life, on Facebook, all those kind of things. It takes a lot. It is stressful. If you are involved, it's stressful. Many of you just think it's ordinary preaching. It's not ordinary preaching. Preaching involves it tasks your brain, tasks your spirit, tasks your body. Sometimes throughout the night, I may not sleep 2 hours. But you cannot come and be saying that, yeah, I didn't sleep. No. They will say, who sent you? They will ask you, who sent you? Hallelujah. A job is a work performed for another man, woman, or company for which you get paid. God has made a provision for the welfare of the ministers doing ministry work in the Bible. Clubs pay yearly subscription. Am I right? Those of you that do clubs, they pay yearly subscriptions. Some in thousands, some in millions. Why? Do fundraising, receive donations to pursue and accomplish their purpose. Church has a reason to exist. And without a regular giving, that purpose will surely be defeated. No church can grow without regular giving. No church can grow without financial support. So now let's go on now. Difference between ministry and church now. Ministry is individual work of the members as assigned by the Holy Spirit. You can underline that in your hand. Ministry is what? Individual work of the members as assigned by the Holy Spirit. Physical church is a building where Christians worship. Spiritual church is a combination of ministries of every member for the blessing of one another. It's good to understand this. When you get ministry, if you have ministries, that's plural. That is a combination of ministries. A church is a combination of ministries. I'm doing my own now. The singer will do their own. Bishop will do his own. Everybody will do their own. You two as a member, you do your own, you play your own part here. There are some parts you play in the church. There are some parts you play where you are working. Where you are working, you are a minister. You have a ministry there. You mustn't be afraid to pray. When they say, give us prayer, don't be afraid. When they say, give us word of encouragement, don't be afraid to speak. When they are talking about faith, don't be afraid to express your faith and to stand for whom you are and whom you believe. It's your ministry. Romans 12, verse 4. For we have many members in one body. Many what? Members in one body. And all members have not the same office. That is ministry. All members have not same office. So we, being many, being what? Many are one member in Christ. And everyone members of one of another. So I'm contributing my own now. You two have something to contribute. You are not just here to be healed. After you are healed and delivered, what next? To just come to church and sit down and be looking? After God saves you, you are healed. After God saves you, devil goes out. After God heals you, what next? To come and sit down every day and do nothing? That is never the purpose why God heals you. God heals you, he delivers you that you may serve. You may have the energy and the grace to serve him. You are saved, you are redeemed to serve. And you must know area of service. Are we going to understand what I'm talking about? Amen. Now, let's begin to go now. Ministry is personal. Colossians 4:17. Ministry is personal. And say to Archippus, take heed to the ministry which thou hast received in the Lord, that thou fulfill it. Is that not clear enough? Paul was telling this man, you have a ministry that God has given to you. You have a ministry that God has given. Fulfill it. Do it. You also, you are hearing me now. You are not useless. See that woman of Samaria that has married 5 husbands. See, her only testimony, the first day she got converted, her only testimony, she didn't quote anywhere in the Bible. She didn't know anything about Bible school or anything. Or just her testimony alone, through her encounter with Jesus, that testimony alone brought a whole series to Jesus. Your testimony is the first place to begin ministration. Your what? Testimony. Your testimony is the beginning of your ministry. The man of Gadarene, after he was healed, he hasn't gone to Bible college. He hasn't known all that you have known. He went back to Syria. His testimony alone was enough. By the time Christ returned again to that place, everybody in the city has known that it was that man's testimony that brought the woman with the issue of blood. It was the man's testimony that brought the centurion. Your testimony, if you are genuinely saved, if you have had an encounter with Jesus, if you have ever received any grace from God, that grace alone is enough to witness. Just to testify. Before, this is whom I am. When I met Christ, this is what he has done for me. It's enough. If you too can come to him, yours too will be done. It's enough. You are not expected to quote all Timothy 1:12. And I thank Christ Jesus, our Lord, who hath enabled me. Spiritual gift is enablement to serve. When you receive Holy Spirit, not to speak in tongues only, it is to enable you to do what you can't do by yourself. Who hath enabled me, for that they counted me faithful, putting me into the ministry. Have you seen that? Putting me into the ministry. When he gives you spiritual gift, he has put you in ministry. He has enabled you. He has impacted you for ministry. To serve, no matter how small it is, as an usher, protocol officer, as an evangelist, as a witness, in one way or the other, he has empowered you. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 5. 2 Timothy 4, 5. But wash thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist. Evangelist is work. He mentioned work. Do the work. It's not a title. You are not given title to honor you. Many receive title in the church. Deacon, evangelist, this and that as a honor. No, that, I pray that you will take you to hell. It's a work. The particular title you receive, the office for which you are ordained, I don't bring the responsibility of deacon. I don't bring the responsibility, the assignment of an evangelist. And do you always look for opportunity to do the work? Do the work of an evangelist. Make full proof of thy ministry. He was telling Timothy, encouraged as a spiritual father, said, make full proof. Let everybody know you are called. Let everybody know you have been enabled, empowered by heaven to do this thing. Don't feel inferior. Don't feel that small. Don't feel having no much. Nobody know it all. The little you know, like Apollo, use it.
1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 15.
I beseech you, this is Paul. That's why he raised a lot of leaders. He raised a lot of workers. I beseech you, brethren, ye know the house of Stephanas, that it is the first fruit of Achaia, that is the first convert, and that they have addicted themselves to the ministry of the saints. They are always looking for a way to bless ministers. Always looking for a way to bless those who are serving the Lord. And they are so addicted. You know, for someone to be addicted to cigarettes or addicted to alcohol, but these people, they are addicted to service. They think of nothing, they do nothing, they have no party life. Their only party is to serve those who are working for God. Are we here this morning? Are we getting something? Consciousness of being liberated a lot. You see, ministry becomes so easy. Church become a form for you. Serving become a form for you because you know you are fulfilling a purpose for which you are enabled by God. 1.1. Ministry according to spiritual gift. Ministry is what? According to spiritual gift. Romans 12:7, very quick. Or ministry, let us wait on our ministry. Or he that teacheth on teaching. If you have only one gift, that one gift maximize it. If it's only one thing you do, do it with all your might, with all your power, with every means God gives you. Be the best in that thing. Don't convert other people's gift. Acts 1:25. Acts chapter 1, verse 24. We can use all the references. Just to jump, Acts 1:25, that he may take part of this ministry and apostleship, for which Judas by transgression fell, that he might go to his own place, that he may take part of this ministry and apostleship. don't see their work as a ministry, as a service.
1.2 now. Reward according to work.
Ministry is work. Matthew 16:27.
Matthew 16:27.
For the Son of Man shall come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and then shall he reward, and then he shall reward every man, both pastor, leader, member, every man according to his works. So every ministry, spiritual gift is ministry. That's the summary of the whole. Spiritual gift is what?
It's ministry.
Everyone that receives it is to serve. And the reward will come from Jesus according to the work you do with the gift you receive. If we learn everything about spiritual gifts and you don't use it to work, we have wasted all the time. It is to move you to work.
1 Corinthians 3:13-15.
Every man's work, you can see, it is every man shall be made manifest, for the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire, and the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is, either from a genuine heart or from eye service. Fire shall be trying your heart. We try the work. If any man walk abide, which he has built thereupon, he shall receive the reward.
The reward does not come from the bishop, it doesn't come from me. All of us, both member and leader, our reward comes from heaven. If your reward is for this earth alone, then you have been job, not ministry. It's a job.
Can we go on? 1.3 now. Ministry is service to humanity.
Numbers 4:47.
Ministry is service to humanity. From 30 years old and upward, even up to 50 years old, everyone that came to do the service of the ministry. To do what? Service of the ministry. And the service of the body in the tabernacle of the congregation. Whenever you come to the church, you must do, there must be certain thing you are doing. Certain thing you are contributing to the body of Christ. It's not just collecting offering in an envelope and put your $5 or $1 or $10 and say, I've gone to church today for work. No. It's beyond that. Everyone that came to do the service of the ministry, it's a service. So spiritual gift is to enable you. It's a divine impartation for service. The world is waiting for your manifestation. Maryland is waiting for your manifestation. America is waiting for your manifestation. There are people in your community, in your environment, they are waiting for your manifestation. That is what grow ministry. I live in Ota.
Then 1.4, John 4:34.
Ministry is working for humanity in God's name. Ministry is what?
Working for humanity
in God's name. John 4:34. Jesus said unto them, My meat is to do the will of him that sent me, and to finish his work. So every anointing given to Jesus was to do ministry and to finish his work. All the anointing Jesus carried is for work. So where your own anointing should be for decoration? Why your own anointing should be for display in the church alone? Are we more anointed than Jesus? Jesus used everything in him, every grace he carried, to work, to serve. Every grace you have upon your life is to serve. You must always look for opportunity. When you are working in the boss, in the house, Mark chapter 13, verse 34. For the Son of Man is as a man taking the falcon, who left his house and gave authority to his servant and to every man his work. To what? Every man his work, and commanded the potter to wash. Angels and the potters, they are washing on you. Every man is work. So when you receive spiritual gift, before I can't stand before crowd, I'm over ashamed. But when the anointing of God come upon me, I've spoken before hundreds of thousands of people. All the shame, all the fear disappeared. Amen. So when the enablement comes, you begin to do things you can't do on your own. It's for service. It's for work. Then let's see again the book of Mark, chapter 16, verse 20. 16, 20. And they went forth and preached everywhere. All of them. And preached everywhere. The Lord walking. You can see. The Lord was walking with them. And confirming the word with signs following. When you walk, it walks with you. If you begin to walk with the gift you have, he too will begin to walk with you. But if you receive all the whole messages, the whole teaching, and you do nothing with it, it will not walk with you. It will be as if bed is God. If you want to see God, walk for him. If you want to see God in action over your life, in your situation, work for him. No matter how small, everything you can do to work for him. When you work for him, he work for you. You can't be idle and you expect him to work for you. It doesn't happen like that. If you have a son or a daughter that is lazy, will you love him or her? 1.4. 1.5. Spiritual gift is the distribution of work. Acts chapter 9, verse 36. Acts 9:36. Spiritual gift is what? Distribution of works. Now there was at Joppa a certain disciple named Tabitha, which by interpretation is called Dorcas. This woman was full of good works and alms deed, which she did. That was her whole ministry. To give to the poor, the homeless, the widows, giving them clothes. You too can do that. You can begin to collect things. Collect donations, gifts from your friends. Things they don't use, gather them together. Bring it to the church here. Call all the people around. Tell them our son wants to do this for them. See, in the name of Christ and the church, they are giving you this. That is what I study in big ministries. Ministry functioning ministries. They have no church. They have nowhere to go. They gather crowd, bring to the church. Minister Peter can start the fellowship. There he is working. Among his staffs. Maybe every Monday, 30 minutes. Or Tuesday, 30 minutes in the morning or in the evening. Gather them for prayer. And after the prayer, give them some hand bills. If you have no church, come to our church on Sunday. When they begin to receive impartation, administration, you will see that after some few weeks, some may begin to come and say, please sir, I need counseling. They begin to open up to you. And where they begin to open up to you, well, I have done my best. Can you meet my bishop? Can you come to church on Sunday? Can I come and pick you? Are you mobile? That's how church grow. But if you hide your faith, you hide everything, and we are expecting God. He said, those who are ashamed of me in public, he said, you too be ashamed of them. Are we here at the church? Can we go on? So this woman was doing nothing. She wasn't a preacher. She wasn't a miracle worker. She did not open blind eye. She didn't raise the dead, but she was full of good works and alms deeds. And heaven recognized that work.
One point what? Six.
Spiritual gift is a foundation for work. 1 Corinthians 9:1. No. Acts 13:2. Acts 13:2. And they ministered to the Lord and fasted. And the Holy Ghost said, separate me, Barnabas and Saul, for the work whereunto I have called them. They are not just called to receive office, to receive title, to receive, just to be honored. For the work whereunto I have called them. They are called to work, and they work. They die working for Jesus. They die working for Jesus. Separate me. I have assignment for them. When you are serving and serving, in the course of service, God may give you higher service again and elevate you. But you must start working from somewhere. Start service from somewhere. 1.7. Ministry is labor on others. Ministry is what? It's laboring on others. 1 Corinthians 9:1 now. 1 Corinthians 9:1. Am I not an apostle? Am I not free? Have I not seen Jesus Christ, our Lord? Are not ye my work in the Lord? See that last phrase. I am not ye my work in the Lord. We, everybody here is work on the mission. Ministry is working on people until glory manifests. It's working on you until you become at your best. It's working on you until you discover who you are in Christ. It's working on you until you discover the purpose for living. It's working on you until you realize the vision of God for you. It's working on you until your destiny is discovered. It's working on you until you begin to manifest at your maximum capacity. Paul told them, are not ye my work in the Lord? See the job he did on Timothy. See the job he did on many of his disciples. See the transformation that Christ brought about in the life of all his disciples. Look at Peter. What God make of him if he's a man? See someone like me. What God has done in me. My life also has inspired many ministers. So you have our own work here. But sometimes when Bishop talk, many of you don't realize the love. I always tell you, Bishop, people don't know that. When you preach, people don't know that it's for them. You think that pastor don't get tired? You think that no, doesn't pay pastors? You don't know that even pastors who feel pain their leg when standing? But sometimes the love, see, this people must prosper. They must be healed. They must manifest. They must become a millionaire. And when you talk, you believe that this man is wasting my time. But it is the heart. Am I communicating? He said, are not you my work in the Lord? Can we move on? 1 Corinthians 12:11 now. So when you have a grace, when you have a call, when you have a spiritual gift, your work is human being. You have to work in people. You have to work on people. Politicians manipulate followers. Christians don't manipulate. We deliver them. Politicians, they wash people for their own service. A minister, minister to people for their own benefit. But all this worker, that one and self-same spirit, dividing to every man, severally as he will. Corinthians 15, 58. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Spiritual gifts are instruments or equipment of labor for every believer in Jesus. They are for the world harvest. They are supernatural empowerment for making his work easy, faster.